On the second technique, we're gonna start to see yourself giving the guy some options so he reacts and you have the possibility of attacking. A very common way of attacking from the mount is just setting up for the regular choke. And a lot of times, the guy has the reaction of holding you to start to make the bridge. That's common. What we're gonna do differently, instead of coming with the hand like a knife, and the four fingers are like this, we're gonna go with the thumb inside. In reality, once you hold, you're gonna close your fist on the ground like here. So just look for a second. It's gonna be like this. You can even put your weight on top of the arm, okay? What's gonna happen is that he's gonna start to defend as normally he do, but the elbow is pointing this way instead of that way. That's what happened. You lose balance over here. So I'm gonna have my elbow pointing out. And I know he's gonna bridge. I'm expecting this. Notice the moment he bridges, I'm gonna open my knee completely outside. That has to be a fast movement, because if you take it too long, he's gonna surprise you. So basically, that knee is gonna do that motion over here, pointing out. And of course, your other knee is gonna try to follow. Go ahead. I'm moving, the other knee come up. Here, your hip is blocking his arm completely. You pretty much have the arm bar over here. Of course, he might defend, that some other details. But what we're gonna do now is keep what we call the Z-mount, come, and I like to pass my leg before I fall, just not to give him the possibility of coming up. So I pass, sometimes I even tap him from here, but if he's not tapping, I just fall back. And very important, don't fall to this side. You give the guy the opportunity to move it out. Make sure you fall close to the leg. Sometimes you might even hold the leg.